Okay, students, I'm sending you three slides on E.M. Forster's novel, A Passage to India. We are going to read, as I have already taught you, Conrad's novel, Heart of Darkness. I have sent you three or four slides or lectures on that particular novel. Now I'm sending you three, four, or five maximum slides on this novel. Now, this novel, first of all, I am going to tell you about Forster, E.M. Forster. He is an excellent novelist. You should, before you read the novel, you should read about E.M. Forster. Let me read certain lines about E.M. Forster. In 1927, Forster was invited to deliver Clark's lectures at King's College, Cambridge. Forster has delivered several lectures. He also writes several novels on various topics. A Passage to India is one of his best written novels. In this novel, he exposes the destruction brought about by colonial rulers. How did their rule affect the total life of the colonized? That is written in this novel. And this novel is going to expose so many things about the colonizers and the colonized. If you read this novel carefully, a lot of things will come up and a lot of things you will be able to get to know. So be careful and read this novel with as much attention as possible. Lecture number one, slide number one. It's about the novel, A Passage to India. Students, it's a wonderful novel. Do read it, or do read its summary at least, or critical appreciation, or about the characters you must know. A Passage to India by E.M. Forster. Topic, the age of E.M. Forster. E.M. Forster's literary career spans the first quarter of 20th century. The 20th century is the age of complexities and contradictions. The spate of new ideas and inventions has bewildered mankind, and the tensions of modern age has made life oppressive. A new world seems to have emerged, the age of science. Forster's age is predominantly an age of science, an era of material prosperity and affluence emerged. Racial differences have emerged. There were also movements of freedom all over the world. People and nations have been against their colonial rulers. The relationships between haves and have-nots were disturbed. People were more prone towards gaining knowledge and doing research. Advent of democracy and socialism. The outcome of industrial revolution has been the concept of socialism and democracy. It also created a chaotic condition. Religion has become a spent force. Age of Great War of 1914. The Great War was hailed as deliverer in the beginning, but very, very soon people lost their hope. To the soldier, war had left something like a permanent scar on the mind. The war also brought widespread destruction and havoc. There was a global discontent and hatred and dissatisfaction. Slide number 2. E.M. Forster, his life and works. E.M. Forster was born in London on January 1st, 1873 and educated at Tonbridge School and King's College, Cambridge. By the time he became 20, he began to work on novel, although he never finished it. Forster also started delivering lectures at a college. In 1911, he made his first trip to India accompanying D. Lewis Dickinson. During the First World War, he helped in the civilian war efforts.